Hi everyone, today we are going to discuss about accessing Linux file system. File system in general words, it is the organized structure of data holding files and directories, and they are residing on any storage device such as physical disk or any partition. So it should be well organized structure of data holding files and directories, right? And any file system which is residing on SATA or SCSI device that needs to be mounted manually in order to access it in Linux, right? And the process of adding a new file system to the existing directory tree is called mounting, and the directory on which it is mounted is called the mount point, right? So we will also discuss about mounting and unmounting, means in case you want to transfer something from your pen drive to your Linux system, or you want to transfer some data in your external storage device, then how you gonna do that, right? So for that, what I have done, I have connected a pen drive with my system, and it is right now connected to the base system. So we will connect it with our CentOS machine. So this is the data traveler, and we are going to connect it with our Linux system. And after you connect it, then this device is now connected to Linux. But in case, in order to access data which is residing in this pen drive, you need to mount it on the mount point of Linux, right? And for that, any directory can act as a mount point, but Linux has dedicated /mnt and /media directories especially for mounting, right? So what we will do, we can mount the pen drive on /mnt or /media directory, but we will create a different directory inside /mnt so that we might not busy the whole mnt directory for just one pen drive, right? So for that, what we will do, we will create a mount point here. We are going to create a directory inside /mnt with name pd, for example, pen drive, right? And there is a command which is blkid, and when you run this command blkid, it displays you all the storage devices connected along with their UUID, which is universal unique identification number. So this is SDA123, they are your Linux drives, and this SR0, this is the path of your CD, and this /dev/sdb, this is your pen drive which you have just connected, right? So our pen drive is accessible through /dev/sdb directory. What we will do, we will mount it on the mount point which we have just created. So mount is the command, and /dev/sdb, and the name of our mount point is /mnt/pd, which we have just created, right? So this is the method, this is the syntax of mount command. Mount and then space, first argument will tell the file system to mount, and then space, second argument will tell the target directory or the mount point, right? So when you press enter, what it will do, it will mount your pen drive on that directory which you have just specified along with the mount command, right? Means now if you display the contents of mntpd directory, that will display you all the contents of your pen drive, right? So now let's say in our current directory, these are the files and directories which are present. Now let's say we want to send this new directory inside the pen drive. We want to transfer this data, and suppose this contains some important contents which you want to transfer in your pen drive, right? So what you have to do is cp and then name of the source file or the directory, and then name of the destination file, which is here pd, and as we know that it is a directory, so we need to write -a, and means copy the whole folder, Now if you display the contents of mntpd directory, it is displaying new directory that has been transferred to your pen drive, right? So mount command, which we have just discussed, that syntax is mount then space the device to be mounted and after that the mount point, right? Or what you can also write, instead of writing the device, you can specify the UUID here. UUID equals to this UUID, you can specify, right? And after that the name of the mount point. This is the different way, right? So after you are done with transferring the data, then you need to unmount the device by using umount command. So umount space mntpd you can write, or you can also write umount space slash dev slash sdb, that will also do the same, right? So I am unmounting the device. Now when you have unmounted the device, then this directory, this mount point, will no longer display the contents of your pen drive because it is no longer mounted, right? And this is the way in which you do the mounting and unmounting. Now next thing is managing links between files. So links, in simple words you can say, the links are the shortcuts to the files, and links are of two types. One is the hard link and second is the soft link, right? So creating a hard link is the new directory entry with the reference to the existing file on the file system, right? So in order to save the space, and instead of copying, a new hard link can be created to refer the same file, but it needs to have a different file name, right? So for example, what we are going to do, we are going to create a tree here. So I am going to create a directory with name today, and inside this directory I am creating a hierarchy, and inside this hierarchy I am going to create a file with name original, and these are the contents of original file. And now if you display the tree of this directory, you can see that today directory it was already created, but now this tree has been created. So today directory contains this tree, original file is here. What we will do, we will create a hard link of this file in the current working directory. Now if you display the contents of current working directory by using ls-l command, it displays number of files and directories, various files, some random files and directories, right? Now what we will do, we will just create a hard link of the file which we have created, and the command is ln, and after that the original file, name of the original file, and after that space the link name, right? Link name path. So I am going to create a name, create the file with shortcut okay so this file is already existing, so we will create a different shortcut, different name. We'll create a different name, for example link file. So now we press enter, and if you execute ls-l command, then that will display you the link file which you have just created. And if you display the contents of this link file by using cat command, it will display you the same contents, right? And there's a fact about hard link, that is, if all the hard links, they are referring to the same file, they will have the same permissions, same link count, same user, same group permissions. And if any of the information in any of the links is changed, then everything will be changed. And if the original file is deleted, then the contents of the file will still be available if at least one of the hard link that exists, right? So now what we will do, we will try deleting the original file So rm is the command which is used to delete the file. So what we will do, we will delete this original file and we will see that whether the link file still displays the same contents. Yes, right. So this is how the hard links work. So it is just to save the space and it is to avoid copying the files. What you can do, you can create the hard link. And soft links, they are also called symlink, and they can point to a file that is in the different file system, right? And you can create the soft links of directories as well. And if the original file is deleted, then soft link will still point to the file, but the target is gone. So that means the soft link will be called the dangling soft link, right? So now what we will do, we will create a soft link. Hyphen s is used to create the soft link, ln hyphen s, then after that the original file or the directory, then space the name of soft link. For example, I am going to create the hard link on the soft link of slash dev directory. So ln hyphen s then space dev directory and slash root slash device files and ls, so device files, right? So this is same as slash dev directory. And if you enter into device files and you execute ls command, it will display you all the contents of device files, which is same as slash dev directory, right? So this is how hard links and soft links, they work. And okay, so one more thing we will discuss in this chapter, that is the different file types. We know that in Linux everything is a file. So all the devices, your keyboard, your monitor, your pen drive, or any text file or any directory, everything is a file. So what Linux has done, they have categorized the different types in different categories. So there are text files, there are some regular files, there are device files, there are some socket files. So we will see that what different types of files there are in Linux. And if we run ls-l command, that displays us the whole information about files and directories. And you can see that if it is blank in front of any file name, that means it is a regular file. If d is written, that means it is a device file. If l is written, that means it is a soft link. And if you switch to slash dev directory, let's say, because it contains all the device files, and if you run ls-l command, it will display you different files which are having C written in front of their name, right? So if C is written, that means they are the character devices, right? And I'm pressing shift page up. You can see B written over here also. If B is written, that means it is a block device, right? And if B is written, that means it is a block device. And in case S is written, that means it is a socket file. If P is written, that means it is a named pipe, right? So these are the different categories in which files are. So these are the different types of files in Linux, right? So in this chapter, we discussed about accessing Linux file system, mounting and unmounting file systems, how external devices, external storage devices are accessed in Linux, and what are hard links and soft links, what is their significance, and also the different file types, right? So that's all for today. In next tutorial, we will discuss about how to find and how to locate files in Linux. Thanks for watching.